hope was in short supply in the land of Israel. Rome was just one more iron hand. Rome was just one more iron hand in the long history of rules that oppressed the Jews. Then a prophet appeared. Oh, there had been prophets before, prophets like John the Baptizer who had come preaching that the kingdom was close. But this new prophet, this Jesus of Nazareth, seemed so different. Life had touched her. She had watched from afar as he cared for the poor who could give him nothing in return. As he embraced the lowly others avoided. As he put his arms around lepers and made friends with tax collectors, she believed that if she could only reach him, even to touch the hem of his garment, Jesus could change her life too.
Since I met this blessed Savior, since he cleansed and made me whole, I will never cease to praise him.
Passover with his closest friends. He acted with such love and spoke with such reassurance. He gave thanks for the bread and offered up the wine. Yet his disciples had no idea that what was about to happen would give this last meal and this last evening with him a whole new meaning.
Every holy drop of blood you shed.
That evening was filled with sweet memories for his disciples. Jesus told them that he loved them and called them his friends. He said that even though he was going away, he would send someone to comfort them and help them. Later that night in the garden, the sound of the soldiers' footsteps, the smell of blazing torches, and the shouts as he was arrested were ugly, painful scenes seared into their minds. Yet these were memories that could never and should never be erased. Jesus laid down his life to pay the price for our sin. What an amazing sacrifice. What a beautiful gift of love. When Jesus touches you and heals you and sets you free, well, he said it himself, if the Son Son set you free, you are free indeed. Once that happens, you'll want to join all those who have been changed by His grace.